Hi, I'm Nicole, Education Program Coordinator and one of the camp directors at the Peggy Notebaert Nature Museum. And today I have an activity for us all about the concept of biodiversity. And today the activity I prepared, we can actually do completely indoors. Let's check it out. For our biodiversity activity, I created these two example plots, but you could absolutely make a similar recording of your real observations as well. And even though I think it can be really interesting and useful to name and label plants, I want all educators and students to feel comfortable and confident talking about nature and science. So I want to show that we can still do really rigorous science without using those names. We can even talk about the concept of biodiversity together. So we're going to start by observing the plots in general, and since I made these examples, I know the number of individual plants. If you are really sampling outdoors, you may or may not be able to count every individual plant, but I know that in this plot, there are 23 individual plants, and in this one, there are 21. But when we're talking about biodiversity, we're not talking about individual plants, we're talking about the number of types of plants. So let's describe the plants we see and compare how many types are in each. I've been thinking about this grass as kind of like regular grass. It looks like regular lawn grass to me. So maybe we'll call this one lawn grass. This one's a little bit cartoonish, so maybe cartoon flower. And then this one with the little seed head at the top, maybe we'll call that seed head grass. So these are all regular grass. These are all cartoon flowers. And these are all seed head grass. Okay, so in plot one, I see three types of plants. Now let's compare that with plot two. I still see regular grass, I still see seed head grass and cartoon flower, but I also see this flower with the big center, reminds me of a sunflower. Should we call it sunflower? And then this grass where the seed head looks a little bit like a comb, maybe we'll call that one comb flower. And oh, this kind of upside down flower, it almost looks sad. Should we call it sad flower? So now let's count the types of plants we see over here. Regular grass, seed head grass, cartoon flower, sunflower, comb grass, and sad flower. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 types of plants. Now let's think a little bit more about that word biodiversity, and then we'll use these plots to do a little bit of modeling together. Let's check it out. So the word biodiversity, it has these two parts, bio and diversity. Do you recognize the first part, bio? Yeah, this part means life. And diversity, that might be familiar too. Diversity means multiple or many types. So when we talk about biodiversity, we're talking about the multitude or variety of life. So in our plots, we're comparing the plant biodiversity in our plots. To think about this a little more, I want to do a model next. So let's imagine that a rabbit visits each plot, and maybe our cartoon flower is a wonderful food for rabbit. And so rabbit hops through the area, hops through plot number one, and eats every single cartoon flower. And maybe another rabbit visits plot number two, and the same thing happens. Now, let's compare the two plots. It looks like in plot one, there isn't a single other flowering plant remaining. What about in plot two? Oh, I see a couple other types of flowering plants, our sunflower and our sad flower. To think a little bit more about biodiversity, I wonder what would happen now if butterfly or bee visited plot one and plot two. Would butterfly and bee have nectar to drink from a flower in plot one. What about in plot two? Based on what we learned about the word biodiversity, which plot has greater biodiversity? Yeah, it's plot number two. I hope you'll take a little time to talk about or think about why plant biodiversity is important based on what we did in our activity today. Thanks so much.